How did you experience God today? Tagging Rachael.
Hey everybody, my name is Latoya. I thank you so much for coming on to watch this video. Tonight is gonna be a little different. This is gonna be a short video, but it's almost just for the purposes of a video response. I have one of my covenant sisters here in the body of Christ. She is a fellow YouTuber. Her name is Rachael Miller. So indefinitely, please go over to follow her channel. She is very motivational, inspirational, and just a really all-out good person. So the question that she was asked by somebody today was, how did she experience God today? Now that really, really is a powerful question, but it causes you to think, like, do you see the many ways that God takes care of us on a daily basis? One case in point for me today, I had to travel out of town for scheduled maintenance for my vehicle. We had to take care of some business out of town. Now, the route that we take is a major highway, but people from this area know that when we're traveling up this area, you know that you come across these few towns where there's going to be a massive amount of police presence there. It's just a known fact. Many people will say, oh, if you're at this particular county, be careful because they're just handing out tickets. And it was so many traps along the way, speed traps along the way, that I was just like, wow, you know, it's a lot of cops out today. Didn't really think about anything, but I was just so thankful. You know, right before I left town, I tried to get in the mode of teaching my children how to pray, how to be thankful for their food, something as simple as that, having the money to be able to get the food, but also asking God for his traveling mercies. And so I experienced God today, and my children got a chance to see it as well by the Lord keeping us safe on our journey. We saw a horrible accident on the way out of town. We traveled at least an hour and about 7 minutes. And some people may think, okay, well, you know, you may do this route all the time. Oh my gosh, people get on a, I guess a habit or a routine, and they don't think that anything could possibly happen to them on this same route that they take all the time. But you have to be grateful and see how you experience God, even in something that you do that seems mundane on a daily basis. We saw where a motorhome had collided with just a regular passenger car. Now, the motorhome was torn up. This motorhome was huge, and it was torn up, scrapes and bruises all over the side, and they had to come in and lift up the car. And the car was flipped upside down. I mean, it was bad. It was just smashed. And when you think about it, you're like, God, how can somebody survive that? I don't know the end result of this accident, but how I personally experienced God was that God kept us safe the entire way. And catch this, we got back home safely. So everybody, I'm not really sure if you're taking for granted on a daily basis that whatever you're doing that just seems like, oh, you should make it back home. Oh, I know this way. Oh, all you have to do, you can drive this route without even thinking. You forget that you even got home because you take that particular highway or street or back road all the time. And we don't really think, like, it was God's grace and mercy that allowed us to make it that far. So that will definitely be one of the ways that I definitely experienced God today. The Lord allowed us to be safe. So what I want to advise or implore everybody to do is to just be grateful and to just be thankful. No matter what you do on a daily basis, don't take it for granted that you had to make it back home, that it's just an obligation or your right. No, it's a privilege that you travel these busy highways and byways without incident or accident on a daily basis. And that's just my video response to how I experience God today. You all, if you all have not experienced Christ, I definitely want to put a scripture down in my description bar, because it's just important. We are living in some very different times right now. And I really feel like it's important to know Christ. I'm going to end with this. I allowed my children to watch this video as we were going up, and they got a chance to see this young man. I'm not really sure about his life. He said in the video that he never read the Bible. He didn't know much about God or anything. Like, he didn't go to church or anything like that. But he was trending on social media today, and he died twice. So with that being said, he tells about his account of what he saw in hell as he died twice. He got a chance to come into contact with Satan. And so that type of thing, it just really, really allows us to really, really be grateful and thankful that we know the Lord. And I want you all to know the Lord as well. I love you, everybody. Thank you so much. Please like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. And don't forget to go over and to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for my sister, Rachael Miller. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Romans 10 verses 9 states, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Amen.